Bum, bum, bum. Ba-da-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum.
Red Bull Drift Challenge. That's going to require a skill.
So this is the campsite. It's free for people using either the river as passage or the trail. So we parked, had to fill out cards. I brought the bike. We left the bike and the car down there. We're gonna be here for 2 nights. Tomorrow we're gonna hike down the trail and then hike back. We'll be here again tomorrow night. The weather's supposed to be warmer. Hopefully it'll be drier. And that's the little cottage that we're staying in.
Hi guys!
Hello friends!
Thank you.
So this is the little cottage hut thing we're staying in. It's got a fire pit and a grill. And then down here is the river. There's this cool little path right in front of us. We were here last week scouting the place out for Boo's channel, so make sure you go over to MCTDS Outdoor Adventures and check out the video she has, because we'll be using the good camera on hers. And we're going to see how this turns out. I'm just using my phone. So we walked right down there, and we got water. And there's another cottage over here, which is more closed in, has a stone fireplace. But there was a bat in there last week, so we're avoiding that one. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow before we go hiking.
It's right over there. Turkeys, guys. Like on the hill. That light sucks, but I hope you guys can hear the turkeys. It's cool. Okay guys, I know this looks like crap. We're gonna try and go find some turkeys. Sounds like they're on the other side of the river. It sounded like there was one right down here about 20 minutes ago. But Boo was recording, so I didn't want to get out of bed then. And it's really cold. If you know what that other bird is, let me know. Definitely in compete mode with the turkeys. So I think Blue said it's about 6:30. I've been up on and off since about 4 a.m. with the trains and everything else. I don't see any, but it looks like they're on that hillside over there. It's also the side of the river that the train tracks are on. It's right on the other side of the water. I hear them coming from right over here. There's the tracks. I don't know what kind of bird that is. I might have to turn off the autofocus. Okay, we're going to turn off the autofocus. I think that'll help us from there. There's a lot of fluttering over this one. Oh, this is the coolest thing. Alright guys, we'll record some more later, I guess. They're not going to show themselves. I thought they might be right down here near the water, but apparently not. They were the whole way down there, next to the group camp or scout camp that's down that way. But apparently they're all moving now, and they're all moving that direction. So good morning from Wings Over Eden. Hope you enjoyed the turkey noises.
Morning guys. Say hi to Pokey.
Hi.
There she is. So I recorded some turkeys this morning that woke us up at like 6:30 in the morning. And we are currently headed back to the car so that we can grab our bagels we brought for breakfast. And I'm gonna get my motorcycle jacket because I'm cold. I have a hoodie on and my regular thing. I got my pants. But it is only 45 degrees. And last night after we moved in, we had a bunch of campers move in next to us in that group campground over there. It's pretty cool. But all the turkeys were over there on the hill talking all morning. And it was ridiculous. They only just got quiet like 15 minutes ago. And it might be because we were up and doing so much.
They're still kind of gone.
Can you hear?
I think I
heard. Alright, well, I'll put that in the video later. Check out Booze too. I'll talk to you guys in a bit. I can do it.
You to do it for.
Yeah. So 2 minutes of that, guys, every
2 minutes.
30 minutes or so.
Hi, guys. Ooh, the lighting's terrible. We're back home. We've been home since yesterday afternoon, actually. And we actually left early. So we went out for our hike yesterday. We had planned a 2 mile out, then the 4th mile, and then obviously those same 4 miles back for a total 8 mile hike, our first time out. But it was actually too much. Plus, we didn't account for where the, at Cedar Creek, where the camping spots are actually a mile away from where the Greater Allegheny Passage marks Cedar Creek on the map. So mile marker 110 is just outside of like the beach, the boat launch area in the park, where the campgrounds are actually half a mile to 3/4 of a mile farther down the street. So we ended up going on a 6 mile hike, packs, everything included. It was very rough getting out there. Come that 3rd mile marker was pretty bad. We sat down, we ate a very small lunch of pre-made roni rolls, which were delicious, but it was rough. And we actually came right home after that. Boo was in a lot of pain. Everyone was in a lot of pain for the past, for the last mile and a half, maybe mile at the, probably more like a mile. I actually ended up carrying Luna's pack and my pack, and I had hers on my chest, which actually helped my shoulders relax a little bit. But because she was in so much pain, she couldn't actually keep going. It was a really rough walk. So we're thinking about going out again this coming weekend, maybe. But just to do a 4 mile hike, since we know, you know, we're familiar with that distance at least. I think a 4 mile out and back will allow us to stay out the whole weekend like we originally planned. So I rode, where's my baby? There's my baby. I rode my baby back, and they all rode in the car. I think I have an idea for a name, and I think that name is going to be, I'll have that. You know, that British saying where they're like, yes, I'm gonna have that. I really like that saying, so I think that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to put all this up in a video. It'll be up soon. I hope you guys enjoyed it.